Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to start a very beautiful chapter. The name of the chapter is The Born of Love. What is the name of the born? Okay. So what do you think? There can be a relation of love between human beings only?
No. My voice is not coming properly.
So it can be between human being and animals also.
Yes.
Tell me.
Yes, it can be.
It can be between human being and animals also. So this chapter will give you an overview about the relation of a human being and an animal. So I'm going to share screen. Here you can see a pic of a bear. That is a very touching, very lovely story about the love, about the bond between a human being and an animal bear. Okay? And this animal is a wild animal. You all know about this? Bear is a wild animal. But animals also have feelings. They also need love. They also need sympathy, pity. They also feel, you can say, motherly love. So here is a great example of a motherly love that was given to that bear. Okay. And how it was treated just like a own child, just like a child of the family. Okay, so such kind of love and sympathy, care. So that animal was nurtured as a child in a home. So what happens actually with him? How does he come in their family? How did it become the member of their family? And afterwards, what happened? That animal was living for them forever or not, because it is a wild animal. We cannot keep it as a pet in our house. It can be dangerous, isn't it? So this is all about the chapter. Okay, and it is very interesting chapter. You will really feel it. And when you go through this chapter and you are really attached to this chapter, you will definitely feel tears in your eyes if you completely engrossed in such kind of reading. Because it doesn't mean that when you see, watch TV, sometimes you are really moved by the emotions of the characters or not. Sometimes we feel tears in our eyes or not. We feel like them. So when you go through any of the text or any of the chapter and you just absorb completely in that reading, so definitely you are going to enjoy it. You will feel that you are really a part of that chapter. You will not feel that you are reading a chapter. If you completely engrossed completely in that, you will feel that this character relates to you. You are a part of the story. Okay? So you will feel like that. So try this tip. Try to do that. So let's enjoy this beautiful chapter, The Bond of Love. But before that, I just want to ask you any kind of question. Think about that. Imagine about that. Think about that situation in reality. That do you really think that there can be a love, there can be feelings, emotions between human being and wild animal?
Yes. Yes.
Most of you can have pets in your house. It can be a dog, puppy. It can be a cat. It can be any bird like parrot, etc. But have you ever seen, you have kept wild animal? No, I think no. Have you seen in your surrounding, in your neighborhood, in your colony, that anybody is keeping a wild animal at their house? If there is any wild animal, would you like to go to their house? It would be dangerous. So do you think that there can be a bond relation between wild animal and a human being? Okay, you are saying. So now we are going to read about a very fascinating account of an orphaned sloth bear, and that was rescued by the author. Orphaned, what is the meaning of orphaned? It means who is having no father and no mother, no parents. So write down the meaning of orphaned, having no parents. So in that, there was one sloth bear, that is a kind of bear, and that bear was having no parents. Okay? Because of that, it was so tiny, it was a kid, so it was rescued by author. Okay? It means its life was saved by author. So, what are basically sloth bears? Sloth bears are basically found in forested areas. They are found in, you can say, tropical rainforest of India and grassland at lower elevation. They are having very shaggy hair, long muscles, okay? And when they claw, they use their claws to dig, they can use their lips to form a tube, okay, which can go deep into a ground, and there they can go to find out dead trees for their food. And what is their main food? Their main food is termites. What do they eat? They eat termites, and you can hear them suck up their food from several feet away. So that is their quality, that they can suck their food, that is very much at a far distance, but they can suck their food from a very far distance. Okay? So here, you can hear them suck up their food from a several feet away. But here it is also given that they claws to dig, they can use their lips to form a tube which can go deep into the ground. Okay? Or hard to reach areas. It means they can go in that area which is very difficult to be reached, like dead trees for their food. So they can go in that hard areas also. And what is their main food? That is termite. And you can hear them suck up their food from a several feet away. It means they can suck up their food from a very several far distance also. And we can also listen their voice also when they are busy in such kind of activity. From a far distance, we can listen. Yes. Clear? So now let's read about that chapter. Here, this chapter is being written by narrator. Narrator here is sharing about his experience. Okay. So how did he get that Bruno bear? How did he take care of him? So let's discuss about that. Vanshika, you read first, second paragraph.
I will begin with Bruno, my wife pet sloth bear. I got him for her by accident. 2 years ago, we were passing through the sugarcane fields near my door. People were driving away the wild pigs from the field by shooting at them. Some were shot and some escaped. We thought that everything was over when suddenly a black sloth bear came out aiming in the water. Now, I did not shoot a sloth bear randomly, but unfortunately for the poor beast, one of my companions did not feel that way about it and promptly shot the bear on the spot.
Yes. So from this reading, we have come to know that narrator is telling about his experience. Okay. I will begin with Bruno, my wife's pet sloth bear. So here narrator is telling that there is one sloth bear. What is the name of that sloth bear? Its name is Bruno. Its name is Bruno. And Bruno was kept as a pet. Okay. And from where did they get that Bruno? They have got it by accident. Why so? Because 2 years ago, what happened? Narrator and his wife, they were passing through the sugarcane fields, and this sugarcane field was near Mysore. That is the name of a place. Okay. And what was the activity that people were doing at that time? The people were driving away the wild pigs, because on the way there were so many wild pigs, and they were driving away wild pigs from the fields by shooting at them. They were also shooting at them and they were driving them away. So some of the wild pigs, some were shot, they were dead at the place, but some of the pigs were escaped. Okay. So after that, narrator and his wife, they thought that everything was over. But suddenly what happened? There was a black color sloth bear. It came out and it was punching in the hot sun. Okay. So it was roaming here and there in the, you can say, hot sun, because it was a scorching heat. Okay. Here now narrator made up his mind that I am not going to shoot this sloth bear, went tauntly. But unfortunately for the poor beast, one of my companions did not feel the way about it and promptly shot the bear on the spot. So here narrator has made up his mind that here now he's not going to shoot any of the bear. Okay. Not for a good reason. Okay. But there was one of his companion. He shot the bear. Okay. On the way, and without thinking, without, for not any good reason, he shot the bear on the spot. Okay. And read third paragraph.
And he was the fallen animal. He was surprised to see that the black fur on its back moved and left the posted one. Then he saw it was a baby bear that had been riding on its mother's back when the sudden shot had killed her. The little creature ran around its posted parent, making up its own noise.
Okay. So promptly means suddenly, without any thinking, suddenly at once. And prostrate means that it was lying on the ground in a downward position. So what happened? The narrator found a bear from where? It is given there that when he and his friends, they were going on the way. Okay. And they were going through their sugarcane fields, people were busy in driving away the pigs, okay, and they were also shooting at them. But all of a sudden, they got a chance to see at a sloth bear, okay. So what happened where at that place? There was one of the animal which was fallen downwards, and they were so surprised that there was a black fur on its back. And it was moving and lifting the prostrated body. It means prostrate body means the body which was lying on the ground. Okay. So suddenly they got a chance that there was a bear, baby bear, that had been riding on its mother back. When all of a sudden one of the shot came. Okay. All of a sudden one of the shot came. And there was a very small baby bear that was on its mother's back. Okay. And when shot came, what did it kill? her mother. Initially, father was killed. Now, mother was killed. And on her back, there was a small baby. Okay. And that little creature ran around its prostrate parent, making a pitiful noise. So that little creature, who was little creature? It was little bear. And it was running here and there, prostrate. Prostrate means the person, it was lying on the ground. Okay. So it was rounding, taking a round there. And it was making a lot of pitiful noise. Because he was not able to find its father and mother. So it was crying bitterly. It was creating a lot of noise. And this noise was considered not such kind of messy noise. It was a noise, sad, pitiful noise. Because it was feeling helpless. That creature was feeling helpless because father and mother, they both were not responding. And that little creature, it was not able to understand that they were shot dead. Okay, read fourth paragraph.
I ran up to it to attempt the capture. It scooted into the sugarcane field. Following it with my companion, I was at last able to grab it by the scruff of its neck while it snapped and tried to scratch me with its long hook claws.
Okay, now here, narrator is telling that when he saw that pitiful scene, so what was his gesture? What did he do? Okay, he ran up to it and attempt a capture. It means he ran towards that creature and he wanted to catch it. Okay, it scooted into the sugarcane field. So when he tried to catch that creature, so it scooted. Scooted means it ran away. Where did it run away? It ran into a sugarcane field. Okay, so the narrator, along with his companions, it tried to follow that creature. Okay, so I was at last able to grab it by the scruff of its neck. So there was a scruff on its neck. With the help of that scruff, scruff you can say the back of its neck. Okay, so with the help of the back, it tried to catch it. It snapped and tried to scratch me with its long. So what happened when it tried to catch that creature? So this creature snapped. Snapped means bite. So write down the meaning of snapped. See, this creature was too little. It was just like a baby. But it was so powerful, it gave a bite, okay? To narrator, and it also really scratched him with its long and hooked claws, because hooked, you can say this way, curved. Hooked, you can say curved claws. So it was, with the help of its claws, it gave a scratch on the body of narrator when it tried to catch it. Clear, beta? Okay. Now you read fifth paragraph.
We put it in one of the new bags we had ground, and when I got back to the room, I duly presented it to my wife. She was delighted. She at once put a one-putty colored ribbon around its neck, and after discovering the cub was a boy, and she christened it Jules.
Okay. So they put it in a gunny bag. Gunny bag, you can say, that is made up of jute. Okay. Sack, you can say jute. So they put it in that bag, and after that, they brought it to their home. When they came back to Bangalore, because narrator was living where? He was living in Bangalore. So he gave it as a gift to his wife. So what was the response of his wife after getting that bell? So when she saw that, she became so happy and immediately she brought a colored ribbon and she put a colored ribbon around its neck. And when she discovered that it was a boy, she gave it a name, Bruno. Clear? So that bear was given a name, Bruno.
Bruno took to drinking the milk from the water. It was but a step further, and within a very few days, he started eating and drinking everything else, and everything is the right word for he ate
porridge
made from any ingredient, vegetables, fruits, nuts, meat, especially from nuts.
It is curry. See the reading skills. Curry is read as currency. Condiments. Pudding. Pudding.
Ice cream, etc. As for drink milk, tea, coffee, lime juice, agitated water, buttermilk, beer, alcoholic liquor, and in fact anything liquid, it all went down with
relish. Now see. Now, what was his activity now? First of all, she tied a ribbon around its neck. She gave a name, Bruno, to that bear. Now, Bruno was too young, too little. Okay. So, she arranged a bottle. Okay. Feeder, you can say. So, with the help of that bottle, he used to drink milk. Okay. So it was a step further, but within some days, that Bruno started eating and drinking something extra also. So there was a porridge. What is porridge in Hindi? What do we say? Yes. So there was a porridge, and this porridge was made of different kind of ingredients like fruits, nuts. It was also given. Yes, it is carnivorous, but when it was kept at home, so such kind of things were also given to it. But beside that, pork is a meat of a pig, so it is non-veg. So it was given to that also. Curry, rice, such kind of things were also given. There is a word, condiments. Have you ever seen that word somewhere? Where? No, in your surrounding, when you go in any food area. No. Have you ever gone to McD?
Yes.
Have you ever gone to McD? I think you all have gone. So there you get pouch of sauce, sometimes different spices, that pouches are also, sometimes we black pepper, etc., chili flakes, so sometimes oregano, so sometimes we don't use it. So what do we use? We throw them away?
No.
So there is, next time when you will go in McD, you notice this thing, sometimes these pouches are not used by us, these are extra one. So there is one box, and on that box it is written, keep condiments here. It means extra pouch that you are not using, you can keep that in box. So condiments is used for spices, etc. Clear? So next time when you will be going there, you can read from there. Clear? So chilies, breads, eggs, chocolate, sweets, pudding, ice cream, such kind of things were also given to him, and lime juice. So there is aerated water, you can say. Aerated otherwise means gas, full of gas. So aerated water is also available. This water is a, you can say, carbonated water. So that water was also given to that animal. Okay, beer also, alcoholic liquor also, anything liquid. So whatever was given to him, it really used to relish. Relish means it enjoyed to eat. It was enjoying eating all these. Yes, lips packing. So he was just relishing it. He was really having a good taste of all the things. Whatever liquid was given, whenever liquid was given, whatever the hard material is given, he was cherishing it. He was enjoying it. So this was about its childhood. When it was a baby, what kind of food was given to it by narrator's wife? This paragraph is clear? Okay, you read one that Divyanshi, seventh paragraph.
Bear became very attached to our two Alsatian dogs and to all the children of the tenants living in our bungalow. He was left quite free in his younger days and spent his time in playing, running into the kitchen and going to sleep in our beds.
Okay, so now it is given, the narrator, where he was living in a bungalow, and in his bungalow there were already two kinds of dogs, Alsatian dogs, okay, and bear also became attached to their two dogs, okay, and there were some of the children also, those who were living in their tenant house. Tenant means the area which is given on rent. The area which is given on rent. So some of the area which was given on rent, so some of the tenants were living there. Tenants means people who live on rent. These words are very common words and you should use that. In Hindi we say kiraidar, we speak like that. So in English, what is spoken? Tenants. So you should speak such kind of words. If you know, it's better. If you don't know, enhance your knowledge. How many of you are already known to this word, tenant? Tell me clearly. Okay. Okay. So the bear was very much attractive towards two Alsatian dogs. Okay. And some of the children who were living in their tenants' area on rent, they were also, he was also attractive towards them. So that's why Bear was left quite free in his younger days. It means when Bear was young, at that time it was not risky to keep it free because it was not harming anybody. So in front of dogs, in front of children, it was kept free. It can roam here and there in the house, in the whole bungalow. That bear could roam here and there. He could spend his time in playing, jumping, running. He was going into the kitchen. He was also sleeping with them in their bed. So such kind of routine was followed by bear. It was sleeping in their bed. It was going in their kitchen. Okay. So such kind of activity was done by bear. Clear? Now let's move further. One day, you read, Shivansh.
One day, an accident befell me. I put down poisonous radium carbonate to keep the rats and mice that had crawled into my library. Bruno entered the library as he opened it, and he ate some of the poison. Paralyzed himself into the extent that
Now one day one of the accident fell. So what was that accident? There was some of the poison. What was the name of the poison? Barium carbonate. And this poison was used to kill rats, etc., mice, etc. And there were cats and mice in the library. So that's why such poison was kept in the library for killing killing rats and mice. So Bruno entered into that library, okay, and he ate some of the poison. So what happened? There was a paralysis. What was the effect of that poison? He got paralysis and he was not able to stand on his feet. But he was dragging himself on his thumbs and he came to narrator's wife. Okay, so narrator's wife called narrator and they guessed that what basically had happened. So definitely at the same time, they rushed to one of the vets. Vets is a veterinary animal doctor. So they went to vet's residence. So what was diagnosed that there was a case of poisoning, tame bear barium carbonate, what to do? So that tame bear, it means the bear which was kept as a pet, it has taken what kind of poison? Barium carbonate. Now what to do?
Okay? Excuse you, ma'am.
Yes, Dhiren.
Ma'am, what is the meaning of stumps?
Stumps mean he was moving on his legs because he was not able to walk properly.
Okay, ma'am.
So he was moving on his legs. He was just dragging his legs. But here, according to that, himself on his stumps to his wife. Likha na yahan pe that he could not stand on his feet. वो अपने फीट पे खड़ा नहीं हो पा रहा था बट ही ड्रैग्ड हिमसेल्फ ऑन हिज टर्म्स टू हिज वाइफ इसीलिए उसको ड्रैग करके तो ऑन हिज लेग्स ही वाज बीइंग ड्रैग्ड टू हिज वाइफ सो रेस्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर वी विल बी डूइंग टुमारो